So, about 31,536,000 seconds ago, I was tasked to write a piece about time. Time. A broad topic to say the least, but because of my competitive nature, I agreed to let the pen go until system overload stilled its stroke. Bro, when speaking about time, where do I begin? Do I start from the beginning? I mean, do I begin with the Big Bang, Magellan, or the Mayans? Should I speak about pendulums or the space-time continuum? I mean, how do I begin to describe something so vast, so infinite as time? And is it truly infinite? Or does it have a finite end? Exactly how and when did it all begin? Did it all start with this cosmic bubble that would expand and give birth to time as we know it? Is it more or less complex than that? Have our attempts to measure it only taught us the surface of what it is? I mean, oscillating atoms gave us the clue of what time it is, but neglected to mention what time is. Still, you must admit we've come so far from crystals, pendulums, and sundials. Spinning planets in rotation around a star, boy, that took a while. I feel I've been here a spell or two longer than I intended to. Come on, let's continue. Let's move forward and ride this arrow of time through beautiful entropy. Yes, indeed, please believe it gets messy. I mean, our concept of time isn't so orderly, is it? Especially when even the way we experience time is only
a perception
and an illusion. Sidebar, is chronophobia a legitimate fear? Never mind that. Let me double back. Besides, if it's true that everything that has happened, is happening, and will happen already exists at once, then wouldn't time itself tell us that both my perception and your perception of it, though different, are real? Imagine that. Time. Both quantitative and relative. And according to my watch, I ain't got moments to waste. And if there are multiple realities that exist at this given moment, then theoretically not only am I out of time, but I have plenty of it. How confusing. Wait, let me take some time here, slow down here, give me some time here, yeah. Give me a second, give me a minute, give me an hour. Our time is not ours. Let me be brief, because in the end you don't need to fully understand what time is in order to see the beauty of measuring it. It's more than defining a second so that when the clock's ticking, it has atomic precision. It's standardization, it's measurements of duration, it's discovery and the search for new applications. See, today is understanding our location for global navigation, and tomorrow, well, only time will tell.
We'll be right back.